डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू डॉक्टर वेद चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेसर एंड हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। टुडे वी विल सी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिजीज ब्लू टंग। वी हैव सीन पार्ट वन, नाउ इन पार्ट टू वी सी पैथोजेनेसिस एंड क्लिनिकल फाइंडिंग्स ऑफ ब्लू टंग। This is important viral disease of SIP. Here we will see pathogenesis. If you understand the pathogenesis, it is easy to understand the clinical findings and the severity of manifestations. First, there is entry of virus in body through culicoid vectors. Virus rapidly multiply in blood and create a state of viremia. And when there is viremia, animal manifests high temperature. The virus attach to red blood cells. Then the virus localize in endothelium of blood vessels. This is important. Localization of virus in endothelium of blood vessels, and they cause damage to the blood vessels. This is important, and this results to characteristic lesions in the GI tract as well as mouth, as well as nose, as well as whole body. Virus is damages to blood vessels. There is edema because of damage to blood vessels, hyperemia to this damage, and hemorrhage is also due to damage to blood vessels in tissues of body. The virus possesses both characteristics: abortogenic, means virus cause abortion. The other characteristic is teratogenic, means the virus causing deformities or malformations of embryo or fetus, and this cause a serious loss to the SIP industry. Antibody persist for 6 to 7 months in blood. So here main thing is that virus damage blood vessels. It causes edema, hyperemia, and hemorrhages of tissues in the body. Clinical findings of blue tongue. The incubation period is 7 to 10 days. So disease spread very fast. In SIP, the clinical signs are arbitrarily divided into three forms. One is acute form, very severe symptom in SIP. Subacute or subclinical form. Subacute or subclinical symptoms observed in cattle, and abortive form. There is abortion and deformities of the fetus. Now we see all the stages one by one. First, acute form. There is high rise of temperature. We have already seen in pathogenesis, it is due to viremia. And this temperature persists for 5 to 6 days. There is serous, means watery, mucopurulent, mucus, and pus-like, serosanguineous nasal discharge. Serosanguineous means the discharge contains both blood and liquid part of blood, that is serum. So it contain blood, that is serosanguinous. So nasal discharge is serous, mucopurulent or serosanguinous depending upon the severity of the disease. Due to this thick serous discharge, there is encrustation of the nostrils. This discharge becomes dry or remain liquid, and we find that these discharges stick to the nostrils. Because of the edema and severe discharge, there is snoring sound coming from the nose. Animal find a difficulty in respiration, dyspnea. There is drooling of salivation and lacrimation. This drooling of salivation is because of lesion in the buccal cavity. There is a swelling and ulceration of lips, gum and tongue. There is hyperemia, petechiation and a swelling and a reddening of buccal mucosa, dental pad and tongue. This is characteristic lesion. These lesions again due to damage to blood vessels. Continue here the acute form. This mouth regions become cyanotic or purplish due to damage to blood vessels. There is cyanotic and bluish appearance of tongue. This is characteristic, and probably this may be the reason of the name of disease blue tongue. That is because of cyanosis of the mucous membrane, and it looks purple blue, purplish blue color of the tongue. There is severe necrosis of dental pad. Muscle become dry and encrusted and shows burnt appearance, again because of damage to blood vessels. There are cracks on skin of the body, especially neck region, flank region, back region and other parts of the body. These cracks on skin again due to damage to blood vessels. Ulceration and swelling of udder and teeth. Important thing here is there is effect on intestinal mucosa. The feces contain mucus and blood stain. There is severe diarrhea and dysentery. The feces shows mucus and blood, dysentery. When intestine is involved, it is observed that death is a certain. Case is always fatal. So intestinal involvement means a serious disease. Continuation of the acute form. There are cracks and a swelling of coronary band called coronitis. There is effect on sensitive laminae, inflammation of the sensitive laminae of the foot, laminitis. This is highly painful. There is separation of laminae and hoof. There is lameness, stiffness of joint. And in severe cases, there is sloughing off of the hoof. Sip may show torticollis. In torticollis, the head becomes persistently turned to one side. There is turning of the head to one side. And second thing is, it is often associated with painful muscle spasm. Because of the pain, there is contraction. And this type of the action is called as torticollis. Head is persistently turned to one side and there is painful muscle spasms, contraction. This is torticollis. Animal assume arched back posture. That is again because of the severe pain in the body and severe pain in the leg, laminitis, coronitis. Death is generally due to respiratory failure. Blue tongue cause high morbidity, 50%, and heavy mortality ranging from 10 to 90%. If the disease is very severe and in early stages, it causes heavy mortality. When the case becomes chronic, the animal becomes thin and progressively emaciated. We have seen first form, that is acute form. It is very severe form. It is observed in sheep. Now the second form is subacute form or subclinical form. This form is common in cattle, and this form is generally passed unnoticed without symptoms or because of very mild symptom. So these cattle act as a potential source for the infection to the sheep. All symptoms are in subacute form or no symptoms, subclinical. The third form is abortive form. Name suggests that there is abortion of pregnant ewes. Serious loss to the sheep industry. Deformities of the fetus that we have already seen in pathogenesis. The teratogenicity of the virus. It causes defects in the fetus, which results in loss of entire breeding season, a serious loss to sheep owner. Young animals and merino sheep are particularly more susceptible. Friends, share this information to other veterinarians. Requested to subscribe this channel so that this channel can flourish. Thank you very much for observing this video. Next time we'll come with Blue Tongue Part 3. Thanks.